Welcome back. It's the final day of our powerhouse road trip, getting an in-depth look at what's happening in different housing markets around the country, including and especially these days, just how far a $1 million budget really goes. Yesterday, we were in Albuquerque. $1 million goes pretty far there. Today, we're heading out to San Jose, where not so much. It's number 37 of the top 100 metro areas by size. And, you know, our hitchhiker Dom Chu is along for the ride. Prices are up more than 5%, nearly 5% from last year, with a median home price of nearly $1.5 million, according to Zillow. Here to tell us more is Anna Fine of Coldwell Banker. Anna, it's good to have you here. Welcome.
Hi, Kelly. Thank you for having me.
My understanding, correct me if I'm wrong, was that the market out there actually had a tougher maybe 2022, but has since rebounded or firmed up somewhat. Is that right? Or has it been strong all along?
That is correct. We had a little bit of a downturn end of 2022 as the rates continue to rise. But starting this year, it seems like we are back where we were. And it looks like buyers just got used to the new rate. And we are back at super competitive market and a strong seller's market.
So now, okay, let's talk about the strong seller. So $1.5 million and an 8% mortgage equals what per month exactly? How are people really financing or affording these homes?
So I have to mention that our market is unique in many aspects, but one of the unique aspects of our buyers here is that they are highly stimulated by the stock market. So if stock market is performing well, we have more buyers and they are able to afford high monthly payments. So primarily, we do see people put 20% or more towards down payment. We do see a lot of cash buyers as well. So people can still afford. I guess most of the buyers are in tech industry and their income tend to be higher. So it is still an option for them.
So when you look at the houses being sold, is there a difference that you're seeing when interest rates are really low, where people were saying this was going to be contingent on a mortgage versus not? And when you look at the mortgages, are they taking out fixed rates or are these much more variable now?
People are taking fixed rates or it actually varies. I don't see any specific tendency. As I said, we are not as much stimulated by the interest rate as more of what is a stock market doing. But what I've noticed, the biggest difference is, yes, the market is still competitive and we see multiple offers, but it is not as much as we saw before the interest rate increase. So if before the interest rate increase, we saw 20 offers on one home, non-contingent, today we're seeing 2 to 5 offers. And most of the times contingencies are waived fully, including mortgage contingency in our market.
Anna, it's Dom here. The reason why I'm hitchhiking is I'm a Northern California native. I was born and raised in the Bay Area. But when I was growing up, it looked a lot different than it does right now. So please take us through what the quote unquote $1 million home looks like in San Jose, California today.
So $1 million is not going to buy you much here. It will be very tough to find a single family home for $1 million. This home, for example, that we're seeing right now was sold for 1.64. This is a, pretty average home, 1,300 square foot. It was built in 60s. Pretty standard, nothing special. It is not a luxury home. It is very modest, average family home. $1 million probably will get you a modest town home.
How many bathrooms?
$1.7 million for 1,300 square feet,
three bedrooms and two baths.
Is this the top, Anna? Can it ever go up from here? This has got to be it. I know people have been calling it top for maybe 40 years, but this has really got to be it.
Well, I have to say we still saw prices increase. So this home was sold in May. And since then, we still saw a little bit of price increase, even when the rates continue to rise. The demand remains very, very strong, and we have a lot of people who want to live here.